All right, this is my version 4 Hitchcopter. It has been sitting around waiting for completion. It's been about 70-80% complete for the last 18 months or so, and I've just been too busy, or I've got involved in other stuff, and I got to a point where I was doing the soldering wiring harness, and it was really frustrating doing it, and I put it to one side. However, the other week I could have really done with this one to fly it over the water. It was really windy, the tricopters struggled in the wind, so this thing would have been perfect for that. Though it wouldn't have had any of the buoyancy devices on. I'm not sure about that with this, how I can strap some on. I'll probably just do bottles again. But because of that, I thought I would go ahead and finish this thing. I had to more or less redo all my wiring harness. And I got a power distribution board stuffed in there. This thing is reduced in size. I can't remember exactly how much, but it's now between motor to motor. It's 300 millimeters now. I think it was 400, 450 before, possibly. It has been designed to use a 9-inch prop. But as you can see, I've got a 10-inch prop one on here, which isn't exactly ideal. But for testing purposes, I'm going to use this 10-inch Gowie prop. The 9-inch props that I do have are the Graupners, which I use on my TBS Discovery stuff. And I've only got a few of those left, so I don't really want to sacrifice one of my good Graupners on this at the moment. I probably will once I've got the gains and that played around with, and I'm happy with it. I will go down to a 9-inch prop for when I actually take it away with me, hopefully in a week or so's time. Now you can see it is very tight on the camera. Still works on a 10-inch prop, but downside is there's no room to put my FPV camera at the moment. I'm struggling on a position to mount it. This thing was not going to be FPV flown. It was going to be just a line of sighter, but I've decided to try and adopt it to be a FPV. You can see my VTX. It's kind of strapped on the side there. That's a Fat Shark 250 milliwatt. The aerial that I've currently got on is just for powering up purposes, so I don't burn anything out. I've got a proper four-leaf clover somewhere lying around. I just can't find it at the moment, but that will be going on there eventually. And the camera I'm using, that's what all the wiring in that tape's for. It's holding down all my video transmitter wiring. So it does look a bit messy on that side with the tape. The tape is just holding the wire, that's all. I'm going to be using one of these Super HAD Sony cameras, which are pretty good, I have to say. I've had no trouble with them yet. I haven't had them that long, but I know I've got, I've bought maybe about 5 of them now. And they're on various machines. It's just the one of choice at the moment. Cheap enough, and I could sacrifice that if it crashes. And if I lose it in the water, I can sacrifice that. This thing is, I don't know where I'm going to mount it, because of the prop size, obviously. Fitting this on is going to be a nightmare, so I'm thinking I'm going for a bit of a Billy Bodge job and maybe just put it on the main bodywork slightly back, just so I've got some kind of view. As long as I've got, I don't know, 75% of the screen viewing, then I'll be happy with that. It's just going to be a temporary mount to get this thing on. It's going to fly on, obviously, the NASA that I've got, which is, again, I don't really want to sacrifice this over the water, but needs must, I think. Depends on the weather. I might not even have to fly it over the water. But, yeah, I'll be taking a bit more of a risk with this one. It's got the NASA on board, GPS module. It's got a good Futaba receiver in there, which, again, I didn't want to use. It's got some very good ESC, Simon K, optimized. I think the 20 amp ESCs on it. It has got the Sunny Sky motors, which are hopefully going to be good with my 4-cell setup. This, I think the version 3 of this, I think I blew the motors and ESCs on it because I put a 4-cell through it as a test, and it just blew the motors and destroyed everything pretty much. This thing is all geared up for 4-cell and hopefully 3-cell as well. I've got a few 3-cell batteries of high capacity. It's going to maybe run on a 5000. These are a little bit heavy. If I had my choice doing this from new, I'd run it on about a 3,500, 4,000 milliamp battery. But 5, it gets in the air, it's just a little bit heavy. Seems balanced okay as I've got it. GoPro Hero 2 I'm going to use up front on my homebrew mount. This really works well. It's the first time I've integrated it properly into a frame, so it'll be interesting to see how this works. Should work fine. I've had good results with this, and it's got the backup section as well. For when you fly a bit faster, it just removes the vibrations in the forward travel as well. What else? The length of it, I think, I can't remember. This is all going from memory, so the length of it, I think I shrunk it by maybe 50 milli again. I'd have to go back and look at my old drawings to see what sizes I was using to what I am now. But I think, I'm pretty sure it was 50 millimeters all round, maybe even a little bit more than that. And hopefully I can get this in the air. I need to play around with the gains, the setup of the NASA, no doubt. I've got the base settings from the last one, but I suspect this will fly quite a lot different and need a bit of tweaking with those, which I can't do because it's absolutely blowing a gale outside, as it has done for the last few days and is going to for the rest of the week, apparently. I could really do with getting it in the air for a quick test to get a feel back of where the gains are going to be. With the NASA, I'm going to do it on there's like a potentiometer pot you can link to your gains, and I'm finding that's much easier to use that to find like a base setting. So it'll only take a couple of flights in the air, and hopefully this thing will be set up. Most of the props are balanced, apart from that one over there. I don't know where one of my props, these are all balanced, so I have no idea where one of them's disappeared to. I think I must have used it on another machine somewhere. So I might have to balance that one eventually. I'll see what results come off the GoPro. And that's about it with this. All the 3D printed parts. Anything that's red or blue. And the motor mount, you can see that motor mount's already been broken. It hasn't even been in the air, and I managed to stand on that. And that's broken already, but it shouldn't affect the operation of it. And if it flies okay and I get a chance, I'll go and print a new one of those in grey. If I can find some great PLA, and that's about it with this. The weak point is going to be the way I've got the battery mounted. I'm not happy with that. I'm going to probably use Velcro. That strap, if I can find a shorter strap than that, it would be ideal. Might use a little bit of Velcro on here, not sure yet. See what I've got. It's something I think it'll really fly well in the wind, especially. I'm looking forward to getting an FPV camera. Every time I've built one of these and put FPV equipment on, I've ended up crashing it before I can get full use of the FPV stuff. So fingers crossed on this one. Hopefully this one will break the mold of crashing it before I get to FPV it. Not much else to say about that. I have not uploaded all the files because this one's a bit of a hybrid. So if I get a chance, I'll put all the files together and upload everything so it's all there. Do a parts list so you can kind of copy what I've used with the Sunny Skies and the ESCs, etc. ESCs don't matter so much, but I can kind of give a position for the NASA board as well, where I've got that stuck. There's a few things I'd do differently if I was doing this again, but it was a bit of a rush to do all that infill panel in blue. So all of that's a bit of a rush. The wiring was a bit of a rush. The FPV camera is a bit of a rush. And so much so it's not actually on it yet. But hopefully I can figure a way of getting that on. I might just put it on like an L bracket. And here somewhere it might look stupid, but it'll be effective. And that's your lot with my version 4 Ultimaker 3D printed H-copter. Soon to be going in the air. And hopefully staying in the air.